get many things right the first time. In fact, I am told that a lot. Now I know all the wrong turns, the stumbles and falls brought me here. And where was I before the day that I first saw your lovely face? Now I see it every day. And I know that I am the luckiest. What if I'd been born 50 years before you in a house on a street where you lived? Maybe I'd be outside just on your bike. Would I know? See one pair that I recognize, and I know that I am the luckiest.
Before the ceremony can even begin, I have to ask the question, who gives this bride away?
Her mother now.
Do you, Brian Peters, take Jessica Harrell to be your lawfully wedded wife? Do you promise before God, your family, friends, and these witnesses, to love her, to comfort her, to honor her, keeping her in sickness and in health, in poverty and in wealth, for as long as you both shall live, do you so vow?
I do.
Now, Jessica, inasmuch as you've expressed your desire to be united in marriage, I'm going to ask you to take this vow, a vow not only made in the presence of family and friends, but a vow before God. And do you, Jessica Harrell, take Brian Peters to be her lawfully wedded husband? And do you promise before God and these witnesses to love him and to comfort him, to honor and keep him, sickness and in health, in poverty and in wealth, keeping yourself only unto him for as long as you both shall live? Do you so vow?
Do.
Then I ask that you repeat after me. I, Brian.
I, Brian.
Take you, Jessica.
Take you, Jessica.
To be my lawfully wedded wife.
To be my lawfully wedded wife.
I promise to love you.
I promise to love you.
I promise to respect you.
I promise to respect you.
I promise to honor you.
I promise to honor you.
I commit my soul to Jesus Christ.
I commit my soul to Jesus Christ.
I commit my heart to you.
I commit my heart to you.
I commit my love to our family.
I commit my love to our family.
I shall be your friend.
I shall be your friend.
Your lover.
Your lover.
And your husband.
And your husband.
So help me God.
So help me God.
And now, Jessica. I, Jessica.
I, Jessica.
Take you, Brian.
Take you, Brian.
To be my lawfully wedded husband.
To be my lawfully wedded husband.
I promise to love you.
I promise to love you.
I promise to respect you.
I promise to respect you.
I promise to honor you.
I promise to honor you.
I commit my soul to Jesus Christ.
I commit my soul to Jesus Christ.
I commit my heart to you.
I commit my heart to you.
I commit my love to our family.
I commit my love to our family.
I shall be your friend.
I shall be your friend.
Your lover.
Your lover.
And your wife.
And your wife.
So help me God.
So help me God.
The first vows made to the Father. The second vows made to each other. The third vows have a symbol that exemplify the promise that you make, the vow that you take before the world. Is there a symbol, a ring that I may have? Now, Brian, I want you to look at this ring. It is unbelievably tiny. The delicacy and the intricacy by which it took to make this ring is unfathomable. And the purity of this ring, symbolic of the purity of the bride, the time and the diligence that it took to make this is a symbol of the time that it took for God to bring you two together. It is a perfect circle, never-ending love, of course. It is the most precious of metals. As delicate, as precious this ring is, it will take that kind of absolute obsession to love the precious nature of the one that God has put in your life. I ask that you take this ring, placing it on the third finger of her left hand. I ask you to repeat after me. With this ring,
with this ring,
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
And with my body.
And with my body.
I thee worship.
I thee worship.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And the Son.
And the Son.
And the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Is there a ring for the groom? Wow. Now, Jessica, look at this. Not big enough to put a golf ball through it. But the same amount of time, the same amount of diligence took to make this ring. It is also the most precious of metals. And it is also symbolic, the time that it took for God to make Brian. But I want you to know something about this ring specifically, made of the same material, same precious mineral. But it took an awful lot of pounding, shaping, and molding to make this ring. As precious and as delicate as yours was, it took a lot of hard work to make this ring. It's going to take a lot of pounding and labor and work to make Brian into the man of God, the husband that you've made him to be. So God's will is that it's going to take a lot of work, and this is symbolic of that. Taking this ring, placing it on the third finger of his left hand, repeat after me. With this ring,
with this ring,
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
And with all my worldly goods,
and with all my worldly goods,
I share with you.
I share with you.
In the name of the Father,
in the name of the Father,
and the Son,
and the Son,
and the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
So we are finished. The months and months of preparation. And it comes down to this. By the power vested in me by the state of North Carolina, and as a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, I now have the honor of pronouncing you husband and wife. What God has joined together, let no man put asunder. Ryan, you may now kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to present to you for the first time Mr. and Mrs. Brian Peters.
Luckiest.